If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.
Stop being wicked. Stop following American culture because it's destructive to our communities, man. American culture doesn't work for black people. American culture doesn't work for Hispanics and Native Americans. You know America, you know what American culture is? White men killing other white men. That's normal to them. That's why they make so many movies about gunslingers and vigilantes and going and killing everybody. Because that's white culture. What happens when black people do it? Now you have the ghettos all across America. 7,000 black men are murdered every year. Black children are killed in the ghettos from stray bullets. That's what happens when we take on the culture of these devils. We got to come back to our real culture found in the Bible. You understand? What verse you in? Give me Matthew 24. I'm going to prove to you that we are living in the last days. Our lives of being on the bottom in America is coming to an end, man. Our lives of getting the short end of the stick in this place, of receiving no justice, is coming to an end. Every race of people think they can do whatever they want to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, and they don't have to pay for it. That's coming to an end, man. Black people pay for their crimes. Black people, do we not pay for our crimes in America? You know how bad it is in America? Not only do we pay for our crimes in this place, we pay for crimes we didn't even commit. Emmett Till was murdered. Emmett Till was tortured and murdered because a white woman lied and said he whistled at her. And you know what that same white dog said on her deathbed? She said, I lied about it. I lied. That's how bad we live in America. We face justice for crimes we never even committed. Where it's only right, it's only just that America pays for what they have done to the Lord's children. That America pays for what they continue to do to God's children. You understand? And that's the Bible. If you don't understand, the God of the Bible is a just God. The God of the Bible is not Donald Trump. The God of the Bible is not some judge in some courthouse in America. The God of the Bible is not some racist cop. The God of the Bible actually knows what justice is. And God is going to give us justice. And the way he's going to give us justice is by destroying the place that oppresses us, man. That's the sign of the last days. We're going to get some more. Read. Matthew 24 and 1.
The book of Matthew, chapter 24, verse 1. And Jesus went out and departed from the temple. And his disciples came to him to show him the buildings of the temple.
So right now we're reading about when Christ was still on the earth. And he went and he was talking to his disciples. And the disciples, they're looking at all the buildings that was in Jerusalem at that time. And Christ is about to drop some heavy knowledge on these disciples. And the reason why we should care about that today is because Christ didn't speak about what was just going on at that time. Christ spoke about the things that were to happen, that still have yet to happen. And I'm going to prove it to you. Read.
Verse 2. And Jesus said unto them.
And who said?
Jesus said unto them. See ye not all these things?
Christ is saying, you see not all these things? Look at all these buildings in the city. Look at D.C. Look at how big and great and beautiful a city D.C. is, man. Everybody comes to D.C. to come look at the sights and everything. D.C. used to be Chocolate City. Now most residents in D.C. are tourists, are foreigners, people that's not even from here. Well, guess what? Christ is saying, you see this city? You see New York? You see Chicago, you see D.C., you see Jerusalem. Keep reading.
Verily, I say unto you.
Verily, verily is old English for surely. guaranteed, I say unto you,
there shall not be left here one stone upon another.
Christ is saying there should not be one stone left upon another. That's Christ is telling them, you see these buildings right here, you see these great cities, it's going to be destroyed. This is the problem with the white man. They don't believe that America can ever fall. Let me let you in on a secret, Mr. White Man. Let me let you in on a secret, Donald Trump, Proud Boys, Joe Biden. The Romans thought the same thing. The Egyptians thought the same thing. The Babylonians and the Grecians thought the same thing. And guess what? Every last one of those empires are dirt and rubble now. They're ruins. People go and look at a half-built Colosseum, look at dust bowls, and go to Egypt and pee all in the pyramids. All the great empires before America are not what they used to be. They're destroyed. And guess what the fate of America is? Rubble. Fire. When you read about the lake of fire in the Bible, that's talking about America.
Right.
America is going to be destroyed through thermonuclear warfare. World War III. It's coming, man. You're not going to hear this in the church. We're going to tell you the truth out here because the church is not preparing our people for reality. The church is not preparing our people for the problems that we face every day. What are we going to do if our power cut off tomorrow? The church don't even talk about things like that. What will we do if they cut all the power off to the black community? We don't have a network where we could come and help each other. We don't have a game plan. A lot of us don't even have enough food stocked up because we live in such poverty in this place. Well, guess what? Christ was a soldier, and he was trying to get his disciples to understand what's going to happen. And he's saying, these cities are going to be destroyed. Keep reading.
They shall not be thrown down. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately.
And so now Christ has told them, these cities are going to be destroyed. So now the disciples and Christ are sitting private. And they come in, the disciples is coming to Christ. You're going to read in the Bible, the disciples always came to Christ and asked him questions because Christ was so wise. Christ was so wise that he knew things that other people didn't know. And so when you have a man that's so wise like that, naturally you're going to want to know what he has to know. It used to be like that in the black community where older black women would sit down with the younger women and they would talk and give them wisdom. And the younger sisters used to ask the older black women questions. It used to be like that when the OGs, the older black men, would talk to the younger brothers and show them how to fix the car and show them how to do this and change that. But because America has destroyed our people, we don't have that anymore. Well, this is what Christ was doing. Christ was talking to these disciples, and the disciples asked Christ a key question. Read.
Say, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the signs of thy coming unto the end of the world?
The disciples asked Christ, when is the sign of the end and the sign of your coming? Let me tell you something the Christian church does not teach you that is right here in the Bible. Christ coming back to this earth is the end of this society. The Christian church would teach you that Christ is coming back for love, for hugs, for kisses. But that's not what the Bible is saying. The disciples just asked Christ, read it again.
Say, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the signs of thy coming?
What shall be the signs of thy coming? The disciples is asking, how will we know when you're coming back again? Keep reading.
And of the end of the world.
And of the end of the world. Meaning the disciples knew that Christ coming back on the earth a second time is the end of the world. Now let me help you out for all you spooky conspiracy theorists. The earth is going to be here forever. And I'm going to prove it to you in the scriptures. The word world means age or society. You understand? Just like when the Europeans came over here to America, they called this what? The New World. This wasn't a new globe they came to. This was a different society that they came to. The word world doesn't mean the globe. You understand? Christ is saying when he comes back, this society as we know it is going to end. White supremacy on the face of the earth is coming to an end. And Christ is going to be the man to do it. Christ is going to be the one to save his people. You hear Christians say all the time, I'm saved. I'm saved. Saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. You ask a Christian, what are you saved from? What are you saved? Ask a Christian. What are you saved from? They don't know. Because Christ is coming to save his people, the lost sheep of Israel, from the oppression that we face all over the earth wherever we are, mainly in America, man. That's what Christ is coming to do. And Christ is going to tell them, this is how you know when I'm coming back. These are the signs that you should look for to know that I'm on my way back. Read.
Verse 4. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
Christ is telling his disciples, take heed. Listen carefully that no man deceive you, man. Why do you think Christ was telling his followers, be careful and don't let nobody deceive you? Why would Christ tell his disciples that? Because Christ knew that time is going to pass and many people are going to come and deceive his people. And guess what? In America today, black people believe that some white boy is a Jew. Black people believe that our king is a white boy. Black people believe that we're nothing but thugs and criminals and whores and pimps. When that is us being deceived. The Bible says that we are a holy people, a special people above all people. But because we've been deceived by the white man, we've been deceived by Christianity into believing we're nothing. We're nothing but servants and slaves. Christ knew that was going to happen. That's why he said, don't let no man deceive you, man. And the problem with black people, we hard-headed. We didn't listen to Christ, so we deceived. Now we look at a fellow black man as an enemy, when a fellow black man is our brother. Now sisters look at each other like enemies. When they're sisters, we are family, man. Black men look at Hispanic men as enemies when blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are one people according to the Bible. We have been deceived in America by white supremacy. Keep reading.
Verse 5, for many shall come in my name saying, I am Christ.
Christ is saying many is going to come in my name. Meaning Christ is saying you're going to have people that's coming to say, they here for me. They here doing my work. In the black community, who is saying they here doing God's work? The Christian pastors. Our Christian pastors been saying for 400 years in these churches, God told me to tell you. Jesus told me to tell you. Get ready. God's got a blessing. Jesus said, I got a dream. That's who's been telling us that they've come in to do the work of Christ. Well, God says, Christ is telling us, don't be deceived, man. Many going to come in God's name. Many going to come in his name. You understand? Keep reading.
Say, I am Christ, and shall deceive many.
And shall deceive many. If you look at the black community right now, most black people are Christians. I'll give you another one. Most black people are going to turn around and celebrate Thanksgiving. When the God of the Bible says we are not to celebrate Thanksgiving. Many black people are going to turn around and partake in a feast that celebrates the white man murdering 77 million of our Native American brothers. All to get a good plate of food. That's how destroyed we are in America. We talking all this garbage about no justice and no peace in the streets, but when it's time to really show our allegiance to our people, we trade it for a plate of turkey and cranberry sauce and chitlins and mac and cheese. That's how low we've been brought down to this place in America, man. We sell our soul for a plate of food.
Jay Sparks Eats. I roll with warriors and them garments be looking glorious. Feel like 20 sets of fists hitting you, but it's four of us. They always scream squad, but loyalty just mean more to us. Let the 40s bust when it's time, unleash the hunters. I done seen stand up niggas turn into runners. Niggas with weak right hooks turn into gunners. Soldiers in abundance, marching in by the hundreds. We don't hold no punches, we letting them go in bunches. Crawled up out the dungeons and that we do it humongous. Waiting on a hater to flex, we doing lunges. Rappers better give me respect, this beat punished. Really, I don't worry about credit or where it's due. Just know your favorite rapper, a toilet, I'm number two. Camp full of animals like I'm running the zoo. Call me Tyre Warhorn, either call me the Jew. Shit, you can call me the king, I'm ready to rule. Only sharks swim here, rappers get out the pool. Only real spitters can wade in this type of water. A renaissance coming, we cutting your time shorter. You had a good while to get your fares in order.